So this time I'm looking at the book of Daniel, chapter 9, and we're going to go through the chapter, verse 2, starting with, that it says, by books, it was to understand. Now those books we look at is Jeremiah. So Daniel was looking at the book of Jeremiah then. Now Jeremiah chapter 25, verse 13, 70 years Jerusalem was desolate. So for 70 years Jerusalem desolate, right? Now Jehoiakim was desolate from the fourth year of Jehoiakim to the year of Cyrus. Okay, first year of Cyrus. Nebuchadnezzar received tribute. Yeah. Now we know about Nebuchadnezzar as well from extra-biblical authorities. Such as in archaeology and such. Tribute increased, we are told, and then the city and the temple become desolate, and then you have the captivity. The account is set in Chronicles 36, verse 21. The thing is, the promise to restore after 70 years is in verse 3. So when they seek God, as the Bible says, seek ye the Lord, while he may be found, as Isaiah was saying, and a call upon him. That's what you see in verse 3, when the people and Daniel set his face to seek the Lord. And then in verse 5, we've got the confession of the sins. And Solomon, we know he did the consecration of the first of the temple. And when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, like them which dreamed. Somebody pointed that out about Peter when he got out of prison. He was like them that dream when his captivity was over, you know, from the prison he was taken out. When they shall say, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, right? That's what Jesus said. Then it says that the Jewish people would be saved. And they say, Hosanna to the Son of David. And so, all Israel shall be saved. Romans chapter 11. Now, if you look at your king, it says, he's come to you riding upon an ass, the foal of a donkey. That's another prophecy. And it says, they shall look on me whom they have pierced. Yeah. So, who was the last king of Israel? Some would say Herod, and then it was the four governors, okay, Pilate and Herod, the lesser king, but they're all governors. But it says that a king would always be in Judah, Genesis chapter 9 and verse 10. Now, if there's always going to be a king there, how come there was no king after Jesus? Jesus was the king of the Jews. The prophecy was given that the king would come to them upon an ass, which is what Jesus did in his entry to Jerusalem. When it says they shall, when they pierced, it says, his hands and his feet, Psalm 22, verse 16, the Messiah, who is to come. It also says that in Isaiah chapter 53. Verse 6, they pierced my hands, or they pierced, or bruised, is the word there. By his stripes they were healed. In verse 12 of that chapter, princes, right? For under the whole heaven hath not been done, as hath been done unto Jerusalem. That's what it says in Lamentations chapter 1, verse 12. So in Jeremiah we read that they passed the children through the fire to Molech, so that they became very serious and sinful, going after other idols, and under every green tree and such like this, all sorts of idols. Moses warned that when they go after these other gods, that he would bring a curse and threat and judgments on them. which was what happened. And rising early, all the prophets went out and they warned them, the kings and all that, to, you know, mend their ways and to set the slaves free at the year of Jubilee on the seventh year. And they did that. But then it says the next day they made them all captive again, so that their crime was even worse. So it says basically we know about how they were. I'll start the next part of the video now.